Good afternoon, everybody. Good evening, wherever you are, whatever time it is. My name is Jewel, and this is the Tropical Update. Thank you so much for clicking play and checking it out with me. Of course, we're looking at Invest 93L, what everybody's looking at now, and what may it do. You can see now at this time in the afternoon, after the 12 o'clock Z run, we do have some heavy precipitation that is building in areas. Still don't have any closure at this time. But a lot of energy, folks. A lot of energy. My point is, do not be surprised if this is a named system in the next 48 to 72 hours. Would not surprise me at all if it does not turn into a tropical storm. Now, if it does, it will be called Cristobal. Okay? So, it might even reach hurricane status before it's all over. Right now, I'm thinking more on a very high-end tropical storm. Of course, we have to remember, these things change. They can change at any time. We've seen it happen many, many times. Regardless, it's going to grow. Probably it will disintegrate some. Then it looks like to me it's going to be absorbed by a low pressure system. And then it's going to come out again. And I'm going to show you everything, including what the National Hurricane Center has to say. I will tell you, though, if you live around the Louisiana and Texas coastlines, you need to go ahead and watch this very carefully and be prepared and have everything ready in case this comes your way. Now, as we look at the European model, I'm just going to use the MyFox hurricane charts right now. Much easier to go to, and they're very accurate. I've checked them all out against others. So let's get going. You can see your time stamp, June the 1st. This goes in 24-hour increments, folks. That's just the way the European model goes. Now, tomorrow, you can see here's the system right here. Doesn't look like a whole lot, but it is a ball of energy. As we move along, we can see by the 3rd, it begins to get more strength. We'll move up, and wow, it's got a lot of strength. This is on the 4th. The 4th. It should be a tropical storm by now, at least. Like I say, we will check out with the Hurricane Center. And then remember, I told you it may disintegrate. Looks like it does. Look at this big high pressure. Push, 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 push. That's all it's doing up against this land here. And we also have these little gyres of thundershower activity and energy. And these little gyres are nothing but little vortexes, okay? And over this way, we are going to have a low pressure system come in. So now we're up to the 5th. We'll go over to the 6th. And what happens? This is pushing. This is pulling. And down below, we have another pressure. This is why it's popped back out now, okay? We have another pressure system popping back out over land as we move to the 7th. If here we go. That's when it's out in the Gulf, and that's what we have to watch so very, very much. This only goes up to the 8th. You can see right in here, still this energy is circulating. And this high pressure system is still over here, down around the northern part of the islands and a little bit of Puerto Rico. And that's what's protecting these islands from all of these little gyres that are coming up right now. So you guys are safe. You may get rain, but other than that, you're safe at the moment. Now, as we see, you can see the color change over here. This is a low pressure system. You can see this is kind of jogged this way. That's because it's low. It's pulling it this way, okay? And this is pushing it, and that's what kept it down up in here. We have another low pressure up here that has come off the coast, and I think this is as far as it will go is the 8th. When we click it again, no, we got one more day on the 9th. You can see it's meandering around the coastline. Meandering around the coastline. Just hanging around. Then when we see what happens again, we're up to the 10th. It looks like it's coming in to Texas. There it is, right there. This little ball of energy. But we'll check some more things out. As of today, June 1st, I just wanted to put the sea surface temperatures up here right quick. You can see how very warm the water is indeed. It's in the 80s, folks, for the Gulf, right on down into the Caribbean, right on down. You see very, very warm waters. We've had a cold front push through. It's eased up right along the coast of South Carolina, North Carolina. Not quite as warm as it was, and of course, this little area here is the current going through from the Gulf, and that's why that's so much warmer right there. But I wanted to point out it's in great water to intensify. Now I want to take a look at the NavGem model. This is the Navy model, okay? We've got it set here for June 1st as we track it on through. If it will load up for us here, let's see what it'll do. Here we go. And you can see the timestamp right in here, what's going on for today. Here's the system we're watching as it begins to track through. This one seems pretty on the ball, pretty accurate. Remember I told you it would come down here and kind of stall out before it came back? And this particular model is showing it right now, and it should push on out in the Gulf. We'll see what happens here. This is tomorrow. Now we're up to the 3rd, which is Wednesday. Still kind of stalling, but it still wants to go out on this particular model. This model only goes to 180 hours out. But now you can see it's hanging around that warm, warm water, and it is beginning to intensify as the pressure drops in it. 998. You can see right in here the pressure is dropping. Somewhere along in here, it is, I think, before it actually gets here, once it gets right down around in here, just a little ways back, I do believe it will be a named tropical storm at that time. You can see how this ball of energy keeps growing. The isobars are not tightly compact, but this particular model now is looking like it's going to bring it up into the coastline here of Louisiana around the 7th of June, where the European model, had it coming in down around Texas here. But either way, as you can see on this model, Texas and Louisiana coastline up in here, you guys look like you're going to get whatever it is coming our way. Well, it's still a few days out. We can't say exactly what it's going to be, but when it hits that land, it starts to die down a tad, but then it looks like most of everything is going back out. And that's what the NavGem model is looking like, the Navy model at this time. Looking at the intensity model for wind speed, some of the ship models out here, they have it as a tropical storm, and looks like in 24 hours, that's what may happen, according to some of the ship models. Now, the other models also have it becoming a tropical storm at different points and different times. As you can see, this one has it 84 hours out. As we come up in here on the IBCN and the icon model here, looking like it's got it becoming a tropical storm down at 60 hours out and intensifying up to 96 hours out. This is the HWFI. It's got it way up here almost a hurricane. I do think, remember what I said earlier? I'm not saying it's going to become a hurricane. I'm saying it all depends on how fast the high pressure moves and the incoming low pressure pulls it. That is too far ahead to tell at the moment. It may reach category of a hurricane, but I do believe in my heart, I know now, it's just looking like it has to become, Cristobal as a tropical storm, and a high-end tropical storm. And what is the latest thing from the National Hurricane Center at 2 p.m. this evening? This is it. 5 days out. See how I told you it was just going to hang around this coastline? Here it is right here. And it's looking like all of the satellite imagery and the radar observations from Mexico is showing that the area of disturbed weather centered near the west coast of the Yucatan Peninsula is gradually becoming better organized. The disturbance will move west-northwestward over the Bay of Campeche later this afternoon, where all of the environmental conditions are expected to be conducive to support development. A tropical depression or storm, like I've been saying, is likely to form tonight or tomorrow. And I will go as far as say maybe Wednesday. I'm still waiting to see how these systems move. But it's going to happen pretty soon, folks. Now, the system is then forecast to drift westward or west-southwestward over the southern Bay of Campeche through the middle of the week. Remember earlier, by the middle of the week, it was already going to be up in the Gulf and starting to approach maybe any of the Gulf states. Well, all of that has changed now because of the way these systems are moving. Now, interest along the coast of the Bay of Campeche. Monitor, please monitor the progress of this disturbance as tropical storm watches or warnings could be required for a portion of this area later today or tonight. Regardless of the tropical cyclone formation, you guys are going to get very heavy rain that's likely to continue over portions of southern Mexico, Guatemala, El Salvador, and Belize, and also western Honduras during the next few days. Now, this thing is going to grow 2 days, 90%, 5 days, 90%. It is going to turn into a tropical storm. We'll have to wait and see what happens if it becomes a hurricane or not. Either way, folks, we're going to have a named Cristobal tropical system not too far out in the future. Now, a lot of you say, well, why are you doing this? This is way down there. It ain't bothering us now. Well, you know, I have people down there and I have subscribers down there, and they matter too. That's why I'm doing this. But if you live anywhere around the Texas coastline, the Louisiana coastline, and I'm still not giving, I'm going to say anywhere from Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, and Texas, the greater chances are looking like Louisiana and Texas. But like I say, too far away. We got to keep checking. Now, by the time we get to Sunday on the regular GFS map here, as you can see, this is tropical, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. This is Sunday, June 7th. GFS model. Here it is, right here. Now you see why I'm saying, you see how this rain is going to affect the west coast of Florida before it's over, parts of Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, and everywhere. So we're just going to click through one little bit at a time here, and you can see why I keep including these areas here. Now, Florida, the west coast of Florida should mainly, you might get some few gusty winds, but yours should be mostly rain as of now. That doesn't mean it might not change, okay? According to the GFS map. I still have my money on the European model, but I also go by the GFS and all of the others included, not just one, many, 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 many. Now, you can see it looks like it starts to weaken some. And this would be on Monday, the 8th. See all that heavy rain Florida's getting from South Florida up the west coast of Florida? So we'll go up a little more, and then this brings it in right on the borderline of Texas and Louisiana. The pressure has come up some at this point on the GFS map. Now I'm going to wrap this up real quick. Like I've got it set for 4 p.m. this afternoon. You can see the system right here. Let's run it on up to Tuesday around 10 a.m. in the morning. You can see it's getting more well organized, but it's kind of stationary. But those little vortexes have come together, or those little gyres, I should say, and they're bringing in more rain and getting more consolidated at this point. This is Tuesday at 10 a.m. We'll go on up now to around 8 p.m. tomorrow evening. Now we're getting this circulation going on right in here, and you can see it's beginning to form on up, and probably by this time it will be a named tropical storm as it intensifies by Wednesday at 12 p.m. Let's move it on up now, and let's get up to Saturday, the 6th, around 6 p.m. This is the European model here. You can see how all of these little clouds have got together and consolidated. Not too bad right in the middle, though. As we turn on the pressure gradient right quick, let's see what it's looking like at this time. It is a low pressure. Pressure's 29.63. That could be a lot worse. We will check out the wind in it. Sustained winds aren't too bad, folks. 30 miles per hour sustained wind. Wind gust at this time is, it looks like it's got one little pocket that's trying to get up there. 47 mile per hour wind gust. I'm just going to leave it on the wind gust for a moment. Let's hop up to Sunday afternoon at 2 p.m. The wind gusts are much larger in swath now, looking like it is getting close to the New Orleans coast here, as you can see, and these wind gusts are 51 miles per hour. Sunday at 2 p.m. We will go to Monday morning around 9 a.m. What happens? This low pressure that's over here, there's a high pressure, then there's a low pressure right up in this area going down around Dallas over here. Then we have high pressure. High pressure's pushing. High pressure's pushing. This low pressure that's right in this area is pulling it up. That's what's happening. So the wind gust at this time, we'll see what they're looking like. 39 miles per hour there. That's not bad. Let's see what this one's looking like. 47 mile per hour wind gust. The sustained wind should be down by now, especially around the coastlines. 27 miles per hour. Nothing bad at all. There's the wind gust again. Let's check out the rain in it. You can see how this rain is going. And we will move on up to around 2 a.m. Tuesday morning. And this has it down here again on the coast. We'll make this a little bigger if we possibly can to see exactly what the location is around Texas, still around Corpus Christi and this area here. It could be anywhere down all the way up to Lake Jackson or Houston. It's too far out to tell. But if you live anywhere on the Gulf Coast right now, from Texas to Louisiana to Mississippi to Alabama, you need to have your act together. You need everything together. Now is the time to do it, folks. Get those hurricane kits ready and your hurricane plans so you won't be caught off guard, because this is just the beginning of what's to come this season. Many storms, I'm afraid. Many severe hurricanes, I'm afraid. So please go ahead, get right. I'll keep you up to date on this. We'll follow it day by day. And probably by Wednesday, I'll be able to nail this thing down and tell you exactly where I think it will go. With all that said and done, be safe, my friends. I love you all. I thank you for everything you do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to each of you. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.